everybody. This is Christopher with AG Productions. Welcome to another video. You know, it's been a while since we've done a Christmas-style video or a mailbag video or whatever you'd like to call it on this channel. And I've actually gotten several packages in the mail recently, and I started opening them, and I got through one and a half, and I thought to myself, you know, I really should be doing this on camera because these videos are a lot of fun. I don't know about you guys, but I really, really enjoy watching people open things that have come in the mail. Even if I don't get to see like the product within the box, just seeing the box is kind of fun and it can be inspirational as well. And I know that many of you viewers out there, many of you who have been subscribed to this channel for a long time, have enjoyed the previous Christmas style videos that I've done. And so, you know what, we're just going to open the rest of the stuff on camera. So, first of all, I'm going to show you the stuff that I've already unboxed, and then we'll move into the three remaining boxes, and hopefully you guys will have as much fun as I'm going to have. Alright, so, as far as the stuff that's already been unboxed, I have one box of Dark Eldar Scourges. Let me see, where can I drop these that they're not going to get broken? Let's put them here. I have one Exalted Deathbringer. Very, very cool model. One of my favorite miniatures from the new Age of Sigmar line. And then I have a slew of models that I was very, very excited to see. I had seen some of them in the Death Watch Overkill. I think that's what it's called. Isn't that what it's called? Yes, Death Watch Overkill. I have to look because it's over there. Back in May or June or whenever that was released. And I never thought that GW would actually come in and bring the Gene Stealer Hybrid army back to life. Gene Stealer Hybrids was where I started back in second edition of Warhammer, when I was actually playing Warhammer 40K. And eventually, obviously, I dropped out of the gaming aspect and turned to mostly the painting aspect, but I always really had a heart for the Gene Stealers specifically. I enjoy the Tyranids as well, but the Gene Stealers and the Gene Stealer cult really always kept my interest. And it's fascinating for me to see that faction or that army coming back into play once again after so many years sort of being shoved to the side. So what I have here is quite a bit of Gene Stealer hybrid stuff, or Gene Stealer cult stuff. I have a box of Acolyte Hybrids. I have another box of Acolyte Hybrids. And the reason I bought two boxes of these is because you can assemble them in two different ways. You can assemble them like these guys down here, who are more normal looking, or you can assemble them like these guys up here, who are a little more, let me cover up the viewfinder, there we go, they're a little more warped, they're a little more on the Gene Stealer-y side. These guys down here haven't quite mutated over just yet. So I wanted to have five of each, and I know that there's a box of them in that Death Watch Overkill set, but I really kind of want to hold that box closed, and I don't know, I may get to painting it, I might not, but for right now it's just kind of a board game sitting on a shelf, really. And then I bought a box of the Neophyte Hybrids as well. I also picked up the Acolyte Icon Ward, which is a very, very cool model, by the way. And then, for the first time in a very, very long time, just because I like the army so much, and I like the story of the army, I like the idea of the Gene Stealer cults, I actually went out and purchased myself a codex, for no other reason other than to get the lore and the fluff. I have no intention whatsoever of actually playing this again, but I really wanted the book, and I really like it. So, this will be added to my collection. Now, the other stuff that I've picked up is not miniature related. Recently, excuse my top of my head while I'm moving stuff out of the way. Recently, I've kind of gotten back into playing a little bit of Magic the Gathering. Really enjoyed myself. Kind of got introduced into the Commander format, the EDH format. And you know, it kind of sparked or re-sparked my interest in the game and the cards and that kind of stuff. And I realized there's actually quite a few sets that I have not had time or the money to collect in the past. And I got to thinking, you know, I ought to take a little time and take some resources and start working my way through some of these sets and seeing if I can pick things up and just seeing what's out there and just kind of enjoying the just the ambiance of the entire Magic the Gathering world, enjoying opening up the booster packs, enjoying playing some booster draft or some commander, whatever the case may be, even some, just some casual Magic. And so the rest of what you guys are going to see is all stuff that I picked up over the Black Friday week, or weekend, depending on which site it came from. And it's all related to Magic the Gathering because they were all really, really good sales. So, the first thing is actually one I already opened up. This was a box of Dark Ascension booster packs. This came from Dave and Adam's website. They had a great deal all week long on Magic the Gathering stuff. If I recall correctly, a box of Dark Ascension booster packs was either $59 or $69. Very, very inexpensive compared to what I could pick one of these up for on eBay. Now, a couple of years ago, when I kind of got back into Magic after taking about 10 or 12 years off, it was right around the Theros block. And one of my goals at the time was to try to collect every set of Magic the Gathering cards that had ever come out. And I still would like to accomplish that, but at the time, I found that I could purchase a full set of these sealed from Wizards of the Coast on eBay for like $80 or $90. Well, since that time, that was 2013, the price has actually gone up, and if I recall correctly, it's like $120 on eBay. And I thought, you know what, for that kind of a price, I think I can afford to buy a booster box, see how many cards I can pick up, and then just pick up the random spares or the random missing cards off TCG Player or off eBay or something like that. In addition to that, some of the cards have gone up massively in value since that 2013 time. A couple of the cards have gone up into the $15, $20 range, whereas previously most of the cards in this Dark Ascension set were kind of like the cards from Homelands. You might find them for $5 or less. And so I was really excited to find this for as inexpensive a price as I did. So that is box number one that is not actually being unboxed. Now let's take a look at box number two, which, where does this one come from? This is, let's see, what does this say? This is Troll and Toad, so another decent place to shop for Magic the Gathering stuff. I have a Shadows over Innistrad booster box. Really love that gothic lore, that kind of gothic horror stuff. Really, really, it's always been fun for me. I've always liked those, the old Universal monster movies, the Hammer horror films, that kind of stuff. The campy horror films from the 1940s and 50s. And so that kind of fits right in. It's just beautiful gothic horror, and I really like it. An Oath of the Gatewatch booster box. This thing was $64.95. I think the lowest price I could find on eBay was like $79. So really, really good deal on this thing. And if I remember right, I want to say this was $79.95 or something like that. Again, about $10 off of eBay. And in addition to that, I picked up these two Kaladesh Planeswalker decks. The reason I picked these up is because for some strange reason, and I don't know why, Wizards has decided that the Kaladesh set, you can't actually complete the set without cards from these boxes. In other words, there are cards in these boxes that are part of the main set that you cannot pick up in a booster pack of Kaladesh. And so you can buy as many booster boxes or bundles or fat packs or whatever you want to call them, and you're never going to find some of these cards. Now, most of these cards are, you know, 50-cent cards, and so they're pretty inexpensive. But Troll and Toad had a sale. Both of these decks, if I recall correctly, were about $9.95 each. And these Planeswalker cards on the front are generally selling right around $6-$7 each, $5 to $7. And so basically, that's half the cost right there. Plus, they come with two booster packs each. I thought it was a pretty darn good deal, so I picked both of them up. So, that was Troll and Toad. Let's have a gander at something else. Let's see here. Let's take a look. This one came in next. I'll take a look at it first. This one comes from Miniature Market, one of my absolute favorite places to shop when I'm picking up deals or sales or things like that. Miniature Market tends to have they tend to have, like, sales of the day a lot of the time, or a daily deal or something like that is what they refer to it as. I can't remember exactly what it is, but it can vary from a, like, HeroClix miniature to a board game, and sometimes you might even find yourself some booster boxes or something like that from Magic. But they did have a very, very, very good Black Friday week sale. It lasted for an entire week. Great, great savings, and I'm quite thrilled with some of the stuff I picked up. Again, going back to Oath of the Gatewatch. This is a set that I missed recently. Honestly, there's not a whole lot of valuable cards in this set. I could probably pick the entire set up for about $120, maybe, if I was kind of looking around on eBay, found one for a bid price instead of a buy it now price. But to be honest with you, with the potential of picking up one of these Zendikar Expeditions, I thought, you know what? It's such a recent set, and the booster boxes and fat packs are so inexpensive during these sales. Let's see, how much did this fat pack cost? This was, let's see here, $32. So about $7 less than retail price, and because my order was over $100, it shipped for free. So that's pretty darn good. But it gives me another chance to pick up possibly some Zendikar Expeditions, and if not, then I can do kind of like I'm doing with the Dark Ascension, pick up most of the set between this and the booster box, and then pick up the little onesies and twosies here and there that got missed. So, really liking this one. Then I also picked up a Eldritch Moon booster box. Again, Gothic horror, gotta love it. Very, very cool stuff. And finally, from Miniature Market, the Shadows over Innistrad gift box. I absolutely love these gift boxes. They make fantastic holders for your cards, and I love taking like an entire block of cards and just putting one in each row, whatever set it might belong to. So like you might have the, well, I guess they don't do three set blocks anymore, so I guess I could divide it into two blocks. But I might have Shadows over Innistrad here, maybe halfway up the middle, and then fill the rest of it with Eldritch Moon or something like that. But you get some really cool stuff in here. You get five booster packs, you get a block of land, some dividers and things like that, a little promo card. But it was inexpensive, $14.95 if I recall correctly. And $14.95 just for the five booster packs alone, well worth the price. So, by the way, I like the way Miniature Market ships stuff. They have this strange bubble wrap. It's like, it's thick, and it squishes to where, like, if I push this one, the air goes into the ones to the side. They're all linked together slightly, so you can't actually pop them unless you squeeze all of it together. It's really neat. I've never seen bubble wrap like this before. Anyway, final package came today. This is from, who's this from? Ah, this is from ABU Games. Or as I first called them when I first found them, Abu Games, because I thought it was some sort of Middle Eastern company. Yeah, that I'm not kidding. Alright, anyway. Last couple of pieces of coolness. We'll start out with the, as Rudy from Alpha Investments calls it, the penny stock of Magic the Gathering, Dragon's Maze. Fat pack of Dragon's Maze. Actually, when I got back into Magic the last time, Theros was just about to rotate in, and the old Innistrad stuff was just about to rotate out. And so the first few packs that I picked up were Avis and Restored, and then there was about a 3 or 4 week period where my game shop had run out of all the Innistrad stuff, and all they had left was the Return to Ravnica block. And so I picked up, I don't know, 10 or 12 boosters each of Return to Ravnica, Gatecrash, and Dragon's Maze. Not a lot of great cards in this set, but I really like the artwork, and I like some of the mechanics, and, you know, it's pretty cool. So, looking forward to getting into this. And then we have a Dark Ascension Fat Pack. This one I was very surprised to see. ABU Games was doing an overstock sale as their Black Friday sale. Everything that they had like an abundance of, they put it up for sale for a slightly discounted price, and then you enter in a little code and it gets you 15% more off. And so This box, if I recall correctly, I want to say was $49.99. So you take another 15% off that, you're looking at $42 roughly. So almost retail price for something that on eBay right now is running for about $60. So definitely cool stuff. And last but not least, if I recall correctly, yes, if I dig through all the peanuts that are in here, I will find yet another gift box. This one in the form of Khans of Tarkir. This is where I stopped playing Magic the last time. I did a few booster drafts of Khans of Tarkir and then sort of pulled back out of it prior to Fate Reforged coming onto the scene. So I kind of have to catch up in that block as well. But you can see, or I can see immediately, the difference in this gift box versus, say, the Shadows Over Innistrad gift box in the construction of the box. Let me show you very, very quickly. I don't know if you can see it or not, but you see, you can look at yourself in the camera there. You see that nice seam and that nice break between the lower half of the box down here and the upper half of the box down here. Now, look what a year previous looks like. There's no seam, there's no break. Box just sort of sits on top of the lower piece. Now, if I turn the box around, what do we have? The box is no longer sitting on the lower piece. The box is actually cracked here in the corner and has been crushed on top of the lower piece on both sides. Actually, this one's cracked kind of on the bottom a little bit, maybe even a little bit over there on the top. So, shoddy construction in the older gift boxes, but still a pretty darn good value. I think I paid like $12 for this thing. And it comes with four booster packs now. This does not come with the five like the Shadows Over Innistrad does, but still going to be a lot of fun to open up. And all of this stuff I'm going to open up on camera for you guys because I'd like to kind of venture out into some other stuff. And I think Magic is a good place to go since I'm interested in that. And a lot of other people out there are as well. So hopefully you guys will enjoy it, and hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to leave those in that comment section right down there below. And also be sure to leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to AG Productions if you haven't done so already. I want to thank you again for watching. I really, really appreciate it. God bless you all. Have a wonderful rest of the day, and I will see you all in the next video.